England and France, two nations with a complex sporting relationship spanning decades. And for all involved, there is added complexity. Players, colleagues, teammates at club level. But such camaraderie must be put aside for now. It is undoubtedly a stern test for both sides. Well, there's a terrific, edgy atmosphere here. The crowd trying to lift England's spirits. Fans waving flags, everybody feeling truly positive about the day. Jim, this one always matters.
Well, I for one don't think that just because there's nothing resting on it, Peter, a game can lose its edge, and certainly not when you're facing opponents like this. So I hope the players will approach this with real professionalism.
Yeah, he's fouled him there. Upamecano. So, Jim, who would you identify as the key man in this fixture?
Well, this guy, Teo Hernandez, for me, has evolved into one of the best fullbacks, Peter. Certainly in terms of attacking contributions, you'd be hard-pressed to find someone as good as he is in the final third, especially with the movement that allows him to receive the ball in those little pockets of space.
Well, quite no argument from me on that one. Hernandez. It's an inviting looking ball, that. Pavard spots it and intercepts. Mbappe. He's left his man. Well, he had a really good run at goal there, but the defence just weren't going to let him past. Hoisted upfield by the keeper. Now it's Mount. Dembele. And it's Griezmann. Giroud gets it back. Madison. He's shifting through the gears here. Delivery from Walker. Pavard knocks it away. And here's a chance. Pavard gets rid without sophistication. Stones. Oh, it's a promising build-up, this. Plenty of really nice passing. Rabiot. And it's Giroud. It's a good foot in there. Out to the right. Dembele. It's a pretty loose pass. Now it's Sterling. And he's had a hit! That is decidedly lacking.
Another example of how comfortable this team is on the break.
Mbappe turns back here, probably the best option. So we're still where we started right now. Here's Tchouaméni. Upamecano. Here's Tchouaméni. And it's Dembele. And here's Giroud. So what can they make of this? Now it's Sterling. He's got away. Sterling. And he's there to belt it away. Oh, he's felt that, hasn't he? Kyle Walker. Played out towards the right wing. Good spot. He's seen the run. Showing good feet. Madison. And here's Henderson. Walker. Referee's had a good look and given a corner. England with their first corner, the first in the game for either side, actually. France can counter properly here. And it's Giroud. Dembele. Rice. Mount. Mount! And that is certainly not what he had in mind.
England certainly look a very capable counter-attacking team. They're direct, they're quick, and to be honest, they're full of belief that it'll pay off.
Rabiot. That is good pressure, just hounded him off it. He is through here!
There will be 1 minute added time.
And he was quick to react. And the first 45 minutes are up. Well, there it is, half-time. Not a bad watch by any means. And the efforts of both sides have been good, but neither have been able to penetrate. And so we reach the break, and the game remains goalless. What do you think we're up to after 45 minutes?
Unspectacular, but solid, and that solidity could yet be the foundation for them to go on and win.
And after 45 minutes, it is still goalless. A change, perhaps, after half-time. Time then for the first substitution of the game.
Well, it looks like they just want to introduce a new focal point to the attack.
Number 24. Coming on
the field.
The
start of the second half.
Number 9.
England playing well with lots of opportunities and plenty positives to take from the first half. Despite this scoreline, converting chances would make a world of difference for them.
Out to the left it goes. Gets away from his opponents. And a header! Decent enough try.
That is a really good chance missed, Peter. Certainly the way he's been playing.
England do appear to have made a half-time change.
Well, I think it's the perfect time to make a change.
Well, that is one way to stop him. That's a decent clearance. And that's the end of that. It all started well enough. Gehi. And here's the... He's one-on-one! England can breathe again, just.
Yeah, they showed a vulnerability until the move was stifled. That'll have stirred a little concern.
Mount. Mount. Oh, we're still waiting for a goal to report here. No, that was never going to make it. Pavard.
The attendance for this match was 96,000.
Through and well into the second period. It is still anyone's game. That pass has been well intercepted. And here's Dembele. He's found a way through. And it's hoisted clear. Stones. Stones looking to penetrate opposition lines. Oh, he's going to be pulled back for that one.
Substitution.
has a shot! Oh, great save, real class.
Well, as tests go, Peter, the keeper has just received an A-plus grade.
Dembele goes short. Looking for the run, and the shot! And yes, it's there! And finally, he has breathed life into the game! It is a good finish. The odds were against him, little matter.
And Kunku demonstrated great strength there. I mean, he really had to hold his man off and just create enough room for him to be able to get the shot away. And I think it's just top, top play.
After 69 minutes...
Well, it's an inspired substitution. Terrific move by the boss.
I think the manager's claiming an assist here.
So we have our breakthrough.
Look, experienced voices need to be heard now, along with good purpose and urgency, and they can get right back into this.
No, again, there's no way through. And there's his chance to lead the counter. Dembele on a strong run down the right. Dembele making good progress on the right-hand side. Well, the counter-attack will come to nothing because that is an errant touch.
Oh, what a dampener that was, just when we were hoping he'd turn up the heat.
Substitution for England.
So, time for changes on both sides, actually.
Well, you have to feel a little for the player being taken off here. I think he's been made the scapegoat after that, but I guess something had to be done. I suppose it did need a little change.
Bellingham. Could have been dangerous, but it came to nothing.
England really are showing all the necessary urgency, but it's potency they need.
And it's Sterling. Rice. Bellingham. That's good play. And he's in on goal. It looks as though the ref has given a penalty. He has. And that is a huge moment in the context of the game.
It's just a silly one to give away at this stage of the game.
Well, the protest continues, but in the end, they are defending the indefensible. To square things up. A formality, we're level. Not much more than a formality.
I just think the keeper committed himself too early.
England grab the equaliser and we're all square.
England surely know by now that they've put so much work into producing the equaliser that they'll battle on for a winner. You know, it's all one-way traffic for them now, and they simply have to capitalise on it.
And the counter is on. He's in plenty of space here. He's left his man. And here's Rabiot. And collective relief etched on the faces of the defenders. That tackle was certainly sturdy. Looks to go up and over.
You wonder if that's it now, but there may be one more opportunity, Peter, for a late, late steal here.
He's shifting through the gears here. An uncompromising challenge.
Substitution for England,
England are making a change now. Saka getting the call here. It can be interpreted. Massive lead! Early ball out from the back.
5 minutes added time.
He certainly caught him there. It's a free kick. He's had a fair tumble under that challenge. Kane. That's a corner kick.
Substitution for England.
All the big boys are set for this. It's like Land of the Giants in there.
Henderson. Coming on the field.
Chance to shoot! It's loose now and they want to get him back. And he's managed to gift it back. Upamecano.
Look, there has...
And that's that. So nothing between them after all of that. And you can't really argue with the result. Neither manager too unhappy with the outcome. And the fans really well entertained. It's all square in the end. And notably, neither side incurred a booking today. And that doesn't happen very often these days. So there it is. What struck you most about that?
Wow, like so many of these games, that just flew by. There was great excitement in the match, and it kept everybody guessing which way it was going to turn. I think in the end, I doubt that there'll be much cause for complaint. Neither side deserved to lose for me.
So many thanks to Jim Beglin. That's all we have time for. Good evening to you.